In part one of our lesson on oblique triangles and the law of sines, we will derive and use the law of sines. So let's start off with we are given oblique triangle ABC. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the word oblique, an oblique triangle is simply a triangle that is not a right triangle. So triangles either are right triangles or they are oblique triangles, meaning not right triangles. So in our diagram, we have oblique triangle ABC with altitude h. Now remember from your geometry class, an altitude starts at a vertex and is perpendicular to the opposite side. Now that altitude, h, divides the oblique triangle, ABC, the big triangle, into two smaller triangles, both of whom are right triangles. So let's consider for a moment right triangle ABD. So here it is, ABD. Now we could use SOHCAHTOA to find the sine of A. We know it would have to be the opposite leg, which is H, divided by the hypotenuse, which would be C. Now if we take this equation and solve for letter H, then we would need to take the C and cross multiply it up, and we get that H is equal to C times the sine of A. Now let's consider the other right triangle DBC in the picture. So here it is, DBC. If we find the sine of angle C, we know it will be its opposite leg, which is H, divided by its hypotenuse, which is A. And now we're going to solve this equation for H, which means we just need to take the A and cross multiply it up, and we get that H is equal to A times the sine of C. Now, by the transitive property, we have letter H is equal to C sine of A, and letter H is equal to A sine of C. Since both of those things are equal to H, we can set them equal to each other. So we can say that C times the sine of A will have to equal A times the sine of C. Next, we will cross multiply. We're going to take this lowercase c and send it down to the denominator of the right hand side. Take the lowercase a from the right hand side and send it down to the denominator of the left hand side. And we get that sine of a over little a is equal to sine of c over little c. So let's look at the relationship in the parts here. We have angle A, and then we have lowercase a, which is its opposite side. So angle A has as its opposite side little a. And if we look over here, we have angle C, and then there's little c. So here's angle C in the picture, and little c is its opposite side. So it turns out that we can make a proportion of the sine of any angle to its opposite side is going to equal the sine of any other angle in the triangle divided by its opposite side. And this is known as the law of sines. So this will work for any of the angles in the triangle. So we can say that the sine of A divided by little a will equal the sine of b divided by little b, which will equal the sine of c divided by little c. Or, depending on if we are solving for the sides of the triangle, we may want to write this in the form of A divided by the sine of A equals B divided by the sine of B equals C divided by the sine of C. And the great thing about the law of sines is that it works in every kind of triangle. SOHCAHTOA only works in right triangles, but the law of sines works in every type of triangle. So the law of sines can be used in any type of triangle. In this example, we are being asked to solve triangle ABC if angle A is 49.7 degrees, angle B is 78.5 degrees, and side C is 12.9 inches. So remember that side C will always be the side that is opposite angle C. Now, when the directions say to solve a triangle, that means find all of the missing parts. Perhaps the easiest thing to find would be angle C, because we can use the triangle sum theorem. We know that the sum of the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. So then angle C is going to equal 180 degrees minus the sum of the other two, 49.7 degrees plus 78.5 degrees. We grab our calculators and enter that in. We find out that angle C is 51.8 degrees. And we mark that on our picture. So now we have a couple of missing sides. Since this is angle A, we know that its opposite side will be little a. And here's angle B, so its opposite side will be little b. We can find the missing side, for example, side A, by using the law of sines. So we know we could make a proportion that says A will be to the sine of A, as we want to use a known side and angle pair here. So we know little c and we know angle C. So we will do C to the sine of C. So what this will turn into then is A divided by the sine of 49.7 degrees is going to equal 12.9 divided by the sine of 51.8 degrees. So notice it's always a side divided by the sine of its opposite angle is going to equal a side divided by the sine of its opposite angle. So we have to get the A by itself. We will cross multiply this sine of 49.7. Now you will have to show this work on your exams. So at this point, you shouldn't be picking up your calculator and doing this division and then rounding that answer off because that will introduce too much error. So first we will show the algebra where A is going to equal 12.9 times the sine of 49.7 degrees divided by the sine of 51.8 degrees. Now, go ahead and grab your calculator and give this calculation a try. Notice that you've got to make sure that your calculator is in degree mode. Make sure you put your parentheses in the right place. So pause the video and try this calculation, and then restart the video when you're ready to check your answer. I just want to make sure that you're comfortable using your calculator properly. In solving for A and rounding our answer to the tenths place, we get that A is 12.5 inches. So box in your answer in your work, and then be sure that you take that number and put it on your triangle. So up here, we will put 12.5 in our picture for side A. All right, next we can find the only other missing side, which is side B. So once again, I want you to try pausing the video. See if you can set up that proportion on your own there, and then restart the video when you're ready to check your answer and see how you did. To find side B, we know we're going to have b over the sine of b, and we want to use the given information as much as possible, so we will use side c over the sine of c. That's the better choice because there was no rounding. We know that 12.9 is an exact value. We know that 51.8 is an exact value. We want to use side c and angle c in our calculation rather than a and sine of a, because a is a rounded off number, so it's less accurate. So here we're going to have b divided by the sine of 78.5 degrees is going to equal 12.9 divided by the sine of 51.8 degrees. To get the b by itself, we just need to cross multiply this sine of 78.5 up to the right-hand side. So we get that b is equal to 12.9 times the sine of 78.5 degrees divided by the sine of 51.8 degrees. So then you entered these values into your calculator and you discovered that B is 16.1 inches. Put a box around it in your work and then come over to the picture and label the side. So when you're done solving a triangle, that means you should have a picture where all three angle measures are in there and all three side measures are in there. You will show your work and then box the answer. Show your work, box your answer, show your work, and box your answer. This is what I'll be looking for when I'm grading your exams. And the best way to make this a habit is to do all your homework this way.